top of him, nor does he want him to have his back. Saadulaev showing patience, so too Imanari. It takes a very special setting up to work those very special submissions. Flash of leg kicks. Inside leg from Imanari. Saadulaev edging forward, sitting behind the jab, and there you see one of those unique attempts to lock up the leg, Mitch.
He's trying to baseball slide and roll inverted. Now Saadulaev's on top, but you can see Imanari starting to scramble. Doesn't want to let Saadulaev control that side control position. You can see the way Saadulaev laced those legs. Now Imanari's trapped in the arm right there inside the leg.
Don't forget later on tonight, eh? Grappling Rules Super Match, Aoki versus Gaffera. A little taste of the grappling right here. Saadulaev working the knees. Close down that.
Watch out, back on the head, watch out.
Imanari quite elbows from Imanari off of his back. Saadulaev trying to get that left hand free, Mitch.
Now he's struggling. He's got a little bit more of the arm, but he's okay to keep it there. Now he's escaped away. Now he's going for that north-south position. We can see that his arm is really underneath the head there. I think he's got a north-south choke, but Imanari scrambles out of it.
You better believe that Masakazu Imanari has seen it all. The only thing probably he hasn't seen, though, is the maestro choke.
I like how Saadulaev's controlling the left leg of Imanari, so he can't stop working back into the guard. He's got his hand clasped over the head now. He's got that north-south choke. Could be, it might be deep right here. You know, we know Saadulaev's got a good squeeze.
Saadulaev needs to turn like a clock to enable that choke. About the halfway point of the opening round, and turn he does. Yusup Saadulaev trying to squeeze out Imanari in the first round. He's turning, he's turning. Imanari in a spot of bother here. And Saadulaev, how's this choke working here? What are the mechanics, Mitch?
You can see the right arm of Saadulaev has got that, he's got his head laced, and his lat is pressing down on the other side of the choke, on the other side of Imanari's neck. But Saadulaev doesn't quite have it, because as he's turning, Imanari's turning with him. You can see a little bit of the face of Imanari starts to go blue, but he shook out of it. Now he's back north-south.
And that was the key, wasn't it, Mitch? That so long as Saadulaev was turning, Imanari had to turn with him.
Exactly, exactly. Now Saadulaev still got dominant position, still got that side control. Imanari's trying to scramble.
You see, Imanari was looking at that right leg of Saadulaev, thinking I could almost get a hold of it. Saadulaev spins around to the other side. Drives a knee to the side of the head. Turtle shell position here for Imanari. It only takes a moment of explosiveness for the wily veteran from Japan to take hold of one of Saadulaev's legs.
Saadulaev brought in special leg lock artists to work the escapes and to make sure he knew every aspect of Imanari's game. And it looks to be paying dividends, because we can see that Saadulaev is just one step ahead of Imanari in a lot of these exchanges. Now he's got still head side control, dropping a little bit of ground power. Look how relaxed Imanari is.
Saadulaev did employ a man whom he called the best leg locker in Russia to train him for this one. The man's name was Akhmetov. He said, Akhmetov showed me absolutely everything that Imanari could possibly do to me. And we worked out a way to defend them all. Saadulaev in side control. Imanari trying to better his position. He looks for the legs of Saadulaev. And here's Imanari's chance. Couldn't get a hold of it. Oh. Like I said, it's just a split second is all it takes for this wily martial arts veteran.
He's going after him consistently. Now he's back into guard. So that was a good little scramble attempt. He went inverted, came away. Went after the lock, came away empty-handed, but he's back in the guard, and now he's able to start working from this position, which is a much better position than the one he was in last time. But
trying to work the head arm choke in the opening round. Jumping front kick there from Imanari. Imanari on the balls of his feet. Trying to stay loose, calm, relaxed. Patience has always been a hallmark of Imanari's style.
You can see his hands are very low, he's very relaxed. You can almost see he's turning away from Saadulaev to show that, you know, he's unconcerned with the stand-up aspect of this match. He's very relaxed, coming in, pushing forward, really controlling the center of the cage.
Imanari always seems to have this very nonchalant look about him, and quite often he uses that to suck in opponents and give them a false sense of security. Now Imanari's turn to look for the late submissions on Saadulaev. Saadulaev might choose to play the late game himself.
They're playing. This is a very interesting part of the game right here. You can see Saadulaev's got the right leg of Imanari, and then Imanari has got the left leg of Saadulaev. But what's most intriguing about this position is that Yusup Saadulaev last year is coming back from an ACL reconstruction. So that has to play in the back of his mind. That's a serious leg injury, Michael.
Who's got the upper hand in this position, Mitch? Is it Saadulaev or Imanari?
Well, you can see that both of Saadulaev's legs are tangled up. So Imanari might be able to move the left leg of Saadulaev there and possibly go after a heel hook. You can see that Saadulaev has that hook, but he's not really doing anything with it in that position because of the other side of his leg. He doesn't have the ashigari where he has the legs triangled around one leg. So Imanari is in a better position here to attack the heel hook right there.
Olivier Coast right on top of the action, telling both these martial artists to keep improving their position. The heel hook, Mitch. Haven't had one myself from what I've heard. One of the most painful submissions in the martial arts world.
It can be. It is terrifying, especially if you're coming back from a knee injury, Michael.
Move
that
position.
Has to be in the back of your head at all times. But you can see this is a very dangerous game that they're playing. And this is Imanari at his absolute best. Saadulaev, God, it has to start moving. He does not want to stay around there.
Imanari may be looking to set up a heel hook on the left heel of Saadulaev. 2 minutes 20 remaining, second round of action.
He's going after it, you can see, but you can see the way that Yusup Saadulaev is blocking that knee from crossing over to his hip.
Go guys,
if Imanari can take his left leg and put it on the hip of Saadulaev, then he's going to be in a lot of danger. So Saadulaev needs to keep that leg as far away from his hip as possible. See, that's what he's doing. That's what Imanari wants. You can see Yusup Saadulaev trying to pry that leg off. That's a bad spot for Saadulaev to be in.
Saadulaev, though, looking very relaxed here. As he said, he put in the hard work during that six-week training camp, employing the best leg locker in Russia. But can anyone emulate the skills of Imanari? Imanari can seemingly pull these submissions out of nowhere, Mitch. Just when you get comfortable, he locks it on and taps you out.
Momentarily let go of the leg, and Saadulaev almost got away from him. But you could see the way that Imanari sucked his legs back in and was able to get control. There's not a lot of danger here because you can see that Imanari's right leg is right there over the lower part of Saadulaev's leg. So Imanari needs to get that leg a little bit higher onto the hip to get better control of the leg.
A very knowledgeable martial arts crowd here in Jakarta on the edge of their seats, ooing and ahhing every time either Saadulaev or Imanari inches closer to a potential submission. Ground and pound here from Saadulaev off the right hand. Imanari will still continue to hunt for the heel, hunt for the Achilles.
Imanari was trying to slam his head into the fist of Saadulaev. Saadulaev has to be careful because as Imanari is letting Saadulaev punch him in his face, he's making minor adjustments in his leg position so that he can go after that heel hook, toe hold, or possibly a knee bar.
If you're watching in Japan, if you're watching in Russia, martial arts fans around the world, in over 128 countries, you've got to be loving this at ONE Championship. Heel there from Saadulaev to the sternum of Imanari. And Imanari still just a cool cucumber as always. We're going to see the end of the second round. We're going in to a third and final.
Not necessarily in a 50-50 leg lock position, but they were kind of in the same similar position, and Saadulaev was the one adding strength. I think at this point, Saadulaev may be ahead.
Saw Imanari a moment ago employ that baseball slide to try and capture the ankle of Saadulaev. Always the innovator, Masakazu Imanari, master of the leg locks. And now Saadulaev back to the middle side control position, a dominant position for Yusup Saadulaev. So many options from here. Could go knee on belly, could drive the knees into the ribs, but he decides on the reverse elbows. Far side of the body there from Yusup Saadulaev.
Saadulaev isn't scared of the ground game. He's only tentative when it comes to that leg lock. And you can see that he was very comfortable when he was being attacked by the leg lock specialist, but he was able to defend correctly. He did everything right.
You are seeing two martial arts masters in the cage at the moment. Saadulaev told us yesterday he was confident he could finish the contest by a ground and pound. Imanari did predict a first round leg lock.
Arm triangle.
And no, the same technique he tried to use for the finish of the first. Not successful there for Saadulaev later in this contest. In control is the Russian Mitch.
We typically see a lot of Japanese martial arts giving up their back because it's kind of use it in a rest position. But Saadulaev has such a squeeze. He's got that maestro choke. He could possibly go right here if he laces under the neck and cranks down as he pulls Imanari up to a seated position.
Could you imagine if the first ever submission on Imanari is a maestro choke from Saadulaev?
There it is. He's getting close. He's got the one hook in. Imanari scrambles out of it. He knows that he doesn't want to be there.
He knew what was possibly coming. One of the most painful chokes in the world, and he wanted none of it. And Saadulaev in control. A little popping hammer fist strike. There's another one from the Russian. Where does Imanari go from here, Mitch?
Imanari's got to scramble up. You can see the knee ride that Saadulaev is implying. See, he's starting to turn into it, but he can't go anywhere. Saadulaev was able to keep that left leg inside near the stomach of Imanari, preventing him from really going anywhere. He's so strong, he had that over under control. There was no place for Imanari to go except to turn on his back. He thinks in this position he might have a better option to scramble out.
It's Saadulaev doing all the work at the moment. Therefore, he must be impressing the judges. Time now becomes the enemy of Imanari with 1 minute 45 remaining. You can see the swelling on the right orbital of Imanari, courtesy of those left hands from Saadulaev.
A lot of the elbows too. He's dropping these short, quick elbows that are scoring, and he's landing. He's doing damage to Imanari. Imanari just can't move because Saadulaev is so strong.
Do you think Imanari is conserving himself for the final minute for one last explosion to try and get a hold of the legs of Saadulaev?
He could dive for a leg. He's a crafty veteran. He's been in there multiple times. He's been in there more minutes than we possibly count. Nice little hip bump there to get back into guard.
And indeed, we have 1 minute remaining. What has Masakazu Imanari, the veteran who's been competing professionally since 2000, got left for the next 50 seconds?
I like how Saadulaev immediately, soon as Imanari got back into guard, Saadulaev pressed Imanari up against the cage to limit his ability to move and attack with submissions. That's a veteran move on a veteran.
Can Saadulaev posture up? Can he break open the guard and launch the ground and pound? You see Imanari controlling the posture, locking up the right hand. Now the hands around the back of the neck, pulling Saadulaev close to him as the seconds tick down, Mitch.
Saadulaev is still with the ground and pound. He's still doing damage. He's throwing elbows to the leg, going back up to the body. He's mixing things up. He's going head, body, legs, elbow. He's consistently changing directions. Now you can see him trying to slide past the guard. Imanari's got that left leg there on his belly, kind of preventing Saadulaev from fully taking the side control.
And time ran out for Masakazu Imanari.
Three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. From the red corner, Yusup Saadulaev.
It's a five-match winning streak now for Saadulaev, dating back to June 11.